Narco killer here. Sir, reporting live from Eminence, Missouri. Sir, what kind of swim trunks do you think are hot this season?
Hawaiian.
Now, do you always wear boxers under your swim trunks?
When I don't have my Speedo.
Is that a sign of abuse, or?
You just gotta keep it packed.
Keeping it packed here in Eminence, Missouri. Live on location. Okay.
Welcome to the Miscellaneous Podcast. I'm your host, Pauly. And tonight's Miscellaneous Misfits, we have Angelus. Hi, buddy.
Hi.
Hola.
B. Dism.
Return of the Dism.
Jaded Spider.
Howdy, folks.
Cocktail Joe.
If it's going to be that kind of a party, I'm going to stick my in the mashed potatoes.
Kira.
Hola.
Scooper, number four.
Hey, yo.
Who's thy sinless rock?
Zach.
Is that Zach?
Yeah.
Wait, did you guys hear me?
Yes.
A little louder, sir.
I'm sorry.
We had Chappie on, but she's going to be in and out because she's updating her stuff. She's here
I'm
now?
Here. Hi.
With a title that says it all.
Is that like your soft rock voice?
What?
Yeah, Mike.
See, yeah, his adult contemporary late night.
Yeah, I mean, I feel like I'm doing a Kenny G song or something.
From Delilah. Yeah, Paulie's doing Delilah.
Hit him with Kenny G. 102.5.
Yeah.
Wow, wow, wow.
Delilah.
Wow, wow. All right.
Hey there, Delilah.
Let's get to it then.
If it's all right.
Did you miss me?
Hell yeah. Yeah.
I miss you.
I miss you.
Sure, I miss y'all. After 10,000 years, I'm free. It's time to conquer Earth.
10,000 years will give you such a crick in the neck.
It's echoing, guys. So we have a lot on our plate tonight. We're going to start off with some talking points. So I noticed one thing that's weird, and I saw Angelus lighting up a cigarette earlier, and I wanted to throw this out there because I miss smoking so bad.
I do too.
I miss drinking.
Yeah, yeah, you're Cocktail Joe without being a cocktail.
Yeah. You ain't missing much, brother.
So we went to a barbecue, what was it, last weekend? Great barbecue. Had a good time.
Yeah.
But there was one person there that smoked, and it was phenomenal. He was like one person away from me, and I was like just perking up like, ooh, what's that? What's that? And he goes, oh, I'm sorry. I'll move out of the way and everything. And I'm like, no. You need to stay. I don't want to smell that. I miss it. Oh, well. Does anybody miss something that they don't do anymore?
Smoking.
Yes. My thumb.
Oh, that's rough, Joe.
Wait, you lost your thumb?
Yeah, dog ripped it off.
Oh, no. Hey, I lost part of my index finger.
Ouch.
It's just weird the way you said that. I'm sorry.
Which?
Hey, gotta bring it up in the weirdest context.
Wait, yes. that was the same barbecue that we're talking about, that you were talking about all the ways you were sneaking stuff into a, you know, gel, and then the former FBI agent shut you up, right?
Yes, that exactly was that one. Yeah.
Wait, what?
Is it the one that I said, fuck those people?
Yes.
Oh, okay.
Well, I must have missed a bunch of stuff.
It was fun. We're meeting new people, and some from our old, and yeah.
And he's like, Chappie, why didn't you come? And I said, fuck her.
Yeah.
That was actually my exact words.
Mm-hmm.
I would leave it there.
Mm-hmm.
All right, so that was this one thing. The other thing I want to talk about is, dude, customer service in fast food is shit. I mean,
unless you go to Chick-fil-A.
Yes. So that's what I wanted to bring up. These are your top three best customer service restaurants around. You ready for this? Number three, Cracker Barrel.
Yeah, I could see that.
What? Okay. I could see it.
Number two. Now, this is only three. You'd think there would be like a top 10 or something.
Oh, hell no.
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 All the other
I'm
ones
a food delivery guy. They're
the
all horrible. Yeah. Except Chick-fil-A.
Yep. So, number two.
I've never had Chick-fil-A, so I don't know.
I wish I had my life together like Chick-fil-A has their lines together.
I know, right?
They are on par.
And they've got good attitudes.
Yeah, right?
I'm like, they could be like swamped with like 90 million customers yelling at them. They got the smile on their face. I have a good day. And you're like, hey, you brought me up. I don't feel like, you know, garbage.
Me up.
My first job was working at Chick-fil-A in the mall at Northwest Plaza.
Wow.
Was it fun?
It was fun. I mean, right.
Uh-oh. Is that me or you?
I did. But I don't know, they are chicken. So give them
Are you hearing all that garble?
They pay me.
Oh, Lord. Oh, Lord, what's going on here?
It's kind of...
Hey, it's Sunday. We're closed.
Was that payday, too, so they gave their money to the church, or what?
No, we got paid on Fridays.
Oh, okay.
It was like Gettiker Superstore. Remember that commercial back in the day?
Oh, yeah.
Gettiker's, yeah.
It's Sunday. We're closed.
That's
no,
true.
That's a... Weekends.
Guess what?
Oh, it's Gettiker Superstore.
Yeah. Oh, Weekends only did it on It's Monday, we're closed. They used to do it during the week, too.
No, Gettiker's was give us a day every day but Sunday.
Sunday, yeah.
Yeah,
that's
there you
true,
go.
Yeah.
So, everybody, we were garbled up over here, so we heard almost none of that.
Sweet!
Huh. Mm-hmm. Go technology.
Yes. What was that?
Yes!
Oh, soundboard.
No, and do you guys want to know the number two? Because you're calling out Chick-fil-A. That's the number one. Number two is Starbucks.
Okay.
Starbucks? Are you kidding me? Yeah, okay.
Oh, yeah.
Can I get a tall chai?
And a large black coffee.
A what?
Large black coffee.
Do you mean a venti?
No, I mean a large.
He means a venti. Yeah, the biggest one you got. Venti is large.
No, venti is 20.
Danny.
Yeah. Large is large. In fact, tall is large, and grande is Spanish for large. Venti's the only one that doesn't mean large. It's also the only one that's Italian. Congratulations, you're stupid in three languages.
What do you guys think? And this is going to, we might as well get this done and over with for anyone else in the room who wants to talk about this or not. The St. Louis new law of, for an open carry, you have to have concealed in carry. For the open carry. What is that about?
You're not even.
Hmm?
They don't even hear you.
You guys not
hear
me?
Overachieving. I don't have any.
Yes, you're an overachiever, Beatism.
Slashing tires, X.
Yeah. Oh, no.
Are you guys not hearing me?
No.
We can hear you.
Yeah, we can hear you.
I can hear.
We're just ignoring you.
So you guys heard what I said?
Yeah.
All right, just dump out if you don't want to talk about it. That's
all off the record. I can't do this.
Yeah, I know. You told me that. So I'm just saying, just kind of, you know, hit mute or something real quick.
I'll mute it. Okay.
Let's chat about this.
Yeah, because I want to talk. Is our door closed? Okay. All right, so here's the deal. So from what I understand is you have to have a special concealed and carry license to open carry now. Am I correct on this?
Yeah.
That's what I was getting from the news report yesterday. Yeah.
They got to vote on it.
Right. Everybody take your time and let everybody talk.
I'm all for it because, I mean, if you go through the concealed and carry class, it ranges anywhere from $65 to $150, depending on who you go to. But it does teach you the do's and don'ts of gun safety. And it teaches you, you know, when to draw your weapon, when not to draw your weapon. Certain conditions that you can utilize your weapon, because your weapon is more of a shield than a sword. So... yeah.
How was a gun
weapon is
a
considered
shield?
More of a shield than a sword.
What?
About that.
Yeah, I don't get
someone's,
that.
If someone's blasting you, bro, it's not gonna like stop the bullets.
No, but I mean, but no. When you've got when you got teenagers, you know, young adults walking around open carrying weapons like that, I get it, it's the law, but have they really gone through any training? This goes for anywhere you go.
No, I totally get with the training, 100%, but I disagree with you on a gun being a shield. That's not. The gun will not protect you from being shot, period. Just like once you send it out, it's out. You can't unsend it.
I think
gun owners who want a CCW, what they call it over here on the side of the river, I think they need to get special insurance too. So if something goes down, you're insured.
Yeah, they do. There are places that offer that.
Yeah, and I do believe that should be the law. If you want a CCW and you want to carry it everywhere you go, you got to have insurance like you do a car. Because anything can happen.
Huh? Well, and so if you get stopped and you tell the police officer, yeah, I've got my CCW on me. Okay, I need your license and registration for your vehicle, and I need your license and your insurance for your weapon.
Yeah, I do believe that. Because like I said, that mechanism that you have, the gun is a mechanism, that could take somebody else's life or do property damage.
Absolutely.
So why isn't that a law throughout the 50 states? If you want to carry it with you and be John Wayne, hey, have some insurance and some credentials. And like you said, training. I'm with that.
I believe in the whole training aspect of it.
Yes.
Now, this is funny because we're all talking about the law abiding side of guns.
Yeah.
Do you feel that there's way more extra crap we all have to do to follow the rules where everyone else that doesn't don't seem to get in trouble for what they do?
Well, gun law, if you're caught with a gun illegally, that's a felony. So that they
but
do get.
Here's my thing with that is there's millions of ways to get a hold of a gun without going around the law, and they're not going to catch it. So you're still going to have guns on the street.
No,
so
I totally.
So it's not really going to solve the problem that they already pre-existing that they already have.
Yeah, but the thing is that with a law-abiding citizen, there can still be accidents with that too. Okay, so
I just
because
want...
you carry a weapon does not make you a safe person because it could go off and you know hurt somebody.
Honestly, if they had something where you had some training certification and maybe some continuous education on it, I would probably be okay with it, you know, to be honest, because I've been, and you can go, you can talk to AA Ron about this. When he and I have gone to the range a couple times, I go to take AA Ron to these outdoor ranges that I go to all the time, and there are people out there with little to no gun safety training whatsoever, and they're flagging you, you know, they're just constantly not aware of their surroundings. And it's bad. It can turn into a bad thing if someone's really not paying attention.
Yeah, and that's what they need. They need the training. They need that. But the credentials is not. And then I think that's what people need to understand. Just because they enforce these laws, it's not going to get them off the street. There needs to be something else done to get these illegals off the street.
They're never gonna get them off the street.
That's never gonna happen. He's right.
It's the Second Amendment, and the only thing that it does is just tells the rest of the world, hey, come on over, try something. You know, I think the Emperor of Japan once said, "You cannot invade the United States by land because there will be a gun behind every blade of grass."
Wow. Yep.
Either legal or illegal.
Yeah, I like that.
Yeah.
Well, this is—he said this back in the 40s.
Yeah. Hey, it's probably worse now. All night, baby. Sandwiches and restaurant stuff is getting a little out of hand. We were swinging by McDonald's, and we called my brother on this because they have a cheddar jalapeno quarter pounder with cheese.
Oh, I'd eat that.
It'd be a good day eating it, but it'd probably be a bad night.
Yes, I'm thinking a bad night.
So speaking about bad nights,
It's go probably ahead. $2 for those jalapenos.
Probably. It's $2 probably like a $10 burger.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And you know, and that's probably McDonald's response to places that are popping up where you get those artisan burgers to go. I mean, for a while, Hardee's was killing it with the artisan burger. No?
Mm-hmm. Oh, yes, they were. They were so good.
I mean, you're talking about a triple stack burger that I could go to Hardee's and get, and I feel like it's I'm eating a gourmet on the burger. It is, but it was great. But now you got places like Culver's. Five Guys is actually getting faster.
So if you guys look in hashtag general, you'll see the picture of the newest invention here. It is the 20 pieces of cheese cheeseburger.
Oh, Lord. Yeah, but that's in Bangkok.
Yes, right? It is in Thailand, but how long will it take to get here? That's all I got to look at, right?
That's constipation in a nutshell.
Am I good to come back?
Yeah, you're good to come back.
I mean,
welcome
you can
back.
Make that yourself. Just take a chunk of cheese and put it between two buns.
That's a
all
lot of
eating.
Processed cheese, man.
Yeah, they have this great thing called a grilled cheese sandwich. It's crazy. It's brand spanking new, but you should try that first before you try that.
That looks like that the cholesterol
anti-poop prune juice, you know, burger.
This looks that's like they call it the juice. Cheese. They call it the cheese monstrosity.
You won't.
Hey, I'm not gonna lie. I took
you won't poop for a
I
week.
Took my
exactly.
I took my ex girlfriend. I took my ex girlfriend to what was that? A Cheesecake Factory one time, and they have everything on the meal. She ordered a grilled cheese sandwich that was like $14.
Whoa,
Holy Mary!
That comes.
I was like, we came all the way here to get. I was like, we all got dressed up, and she ordered a grilled cheese sandwich.
Uh huh.
Did that come with a happy ending?
I was like,
ha, you took my line, man.
That's what I was
most
thinking.
Most likely, no, because she's an ex. So,
yeah. Cheesecake Factory.
I'm just saying, I paid $14.
What did you order?
Korean barbecue.
I got like a pasta meal or whatever.
Oh, okay.
There you go. I like that.
I mean, if I'm going to spend money, I'm going to spend money, but I'm not going to spend money for a grilled cheese sandwich. I asked her if she was a little kid. He goes, I like what I like.
Hmm.
I was like, we could have stayed home. I could have made macaroni. Gave you a.
Yeah. Made you I could have made cheese at home.
And, you know, the menu at a Cheesecake Factory is the equivalent to reading a novel. There's so many pages in it.
Mm-hmm. I still want that menu. Really? It's the one menu I haven't stolen yet.
Oh, wow. I'll tell you what, their brunch is actually really good, though.
Hmm.
They only do on Saturdays and Sundays.
Hmm, that's good to know.
Speaking of stealing menus, you know what I would love to get a hold of?
Hmm.
You know when you go into McDonald's and they got like the TVs that are showing like the burger, you know, in slow motion and stuff? I would love to actually find that and like run it on my TV when people come over and be like, what the
like background?
That would be funny, dude. Seriously.
I don't want the Matrix dropping down on my laptop. I want a cheeseburger being billed.
Yes. That would be so cool.
I'm sure they probably have a screensaver of some sort like that out there somewhere.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. What would be funnier would be if I got a burger that actually looked like that.
Yeah,
right.
I know. Yeah.
Whatever happened to the days of just like the flying toaster screensaver?
Yeah, remember that with the wings? Yeah.
It even played a little song too.
Really?
Yeah. Go look it up. It was a flying toaster.
Is that the screensaver you had to purchase? Because I always hated the purchasing ones, like the aquarium.
No, I think it was. I think it was like a Windows 98 standard. You know?
Okay. Mm.
Yeah, it's like Windows 98. It was the flying toasters, and it had a little song that you could set it to play the song, and you can even it'll even give you the words to it too, so you can like sing along with it.
I got so many viruses downloading the fake aquarium one that was free. Air quotes. Yeah.
Yeah, you should have just stayed off Napster. Yikes, Metallica hates you.
Oh.
Metallica can suck it. Damn. Well, more like it. Lars can suck it. Lars was a you know the drummer was the one that instigated all that crap.
He did that.
Hey, I like Metallica. I'm not gonna lie.
I like Metallica too.
Well, speaking of Metallica,
but Lars is a little bitch.
Speaking of Metallica and Lars and everything, let's talk about our artificial sweeteners. That's a horrible segue. So in the news again, they're talking about how artificial sweeteners cause cancer. And I was laughing about that because I'm like, wait, didn't in the 80s they say that too? With a thing called saccharin?
Sweet and low, right?
Yeah. So I took a little liberty of finding out the history of artificial sweeteners. Would you like to know more?
Yes.
No. Yes.
So artificial sweeteners were first discovered in 1879 by accident.
By who? By what company?
By several companies.
John Smith.
Now, here we go. Here's the deal. So way back in 18, there are these scientists, because coal was the big thing, remember? For all the new industrial things and bazooba guabo. Yeah. So they found that if you take coal, and the byproduct of coal is coal tar, and you mess around with that and heat it up and boil it and bazooba guabo it, it creates an artificial sweetener. And it was found out by different ways, but different people, but the same kind of process is they accidentally found it. And the one guy that I was reading about went out for a cigarette break, and he noticed his cigarette was very sweet, and he noticed it on his hands. So what do? You test everything out in your lab. That probably killed him. But he tried everything out in his lab to make sure that the coal tar byproduct, the sweetener, it came from that. So artificial sweetener is refined coal tar. There you go. Huh. So there's two types of it. You have aspartame and sucrose. All right. Now, the saccharin falls in line with either one. It doesn't really matter. They're all name brands. Kind of like when they talked about those forever chemicals. Remember they just changed the name, Joe, to like Gen X? And be like, no, it's all out now. We're right. Teflon's
good. It's
all
fine. It's all good.
Yeah. Woo, Teflon. Yay.
You just say, right, so, you want pink, blue, yellow, or green?
Yes. So there we go. So aspartame falls under the equal packets and sweet and low. And then you have Splenda, sucrose, saccharin is – oh, no. Saccharin is sweet and low. Sucrose is Splenda and other yellow packets. And aspartame is the equal.
Stevia is a monk fruit.
It's a monk fruit? Stevia! Okay. Well,
all right, so actually, funny story, really quick story about artificial sweeteners. This is how I found out that I was allergic to it. We were at Denny's when I was in high school, and we were, sitting around playing Magic the Gathering and, like, drinking coffee.
Yes,
this is, like, early 90s, too. It's, like, when we first came out. Awesome. And so we're drinking coffee, doing the whole nine yards at Denny's, and I get up to go to the bathroom, and my friends pour, like, 20 packs of, like, Equal in my coffee. I come back, we're talking, someone tells a joke, I start laughing nonsense, like crazy laughing like ridiculous, like loud, like Princess Bride laughing, like, you know, where he's laughing and then just passes out and dies. That's what I did. I didn't die, but I literally just was laughing and just blacked out, passed out, just boom, done.
That's funny.
And they all thought it was like the Princess Bride. They're like, oh, that's hilarious. It's hilarious. And they're like, okay, wake up. And I wasn't getting up. I was lights out, just knocked out. It took the paramedics to show up with smelling salts to finally wake my ass up.
Oh, wow.
And so, obviously now I don't do. Oh, I did it once before when I was at work, and I got called into work and I didn't want to work. It was either work or get fired. So I showed up to work, made myself some coffee, put some Equal in it, drank the coffee, started laughing, passed out, and then went home because obviously, you know, I was not well.
No. Wow.
That's
you made
sad.
Yourself have an allergic reaction?
Yeah, because I didn't want to work.
Smart.
What kind of job was it?
That's a way.
What kind of job was it that you hated it so much that you tried to kill yourself?
I tried to kill myself. It wasn't like a deadly reaction. It just was like I just blacked out. I just passed out. But it was Steak and Shake.
I had a story about Steak and Shake. Joe saved me from Steak and Shake with the Chevy Nova. But here, let me finish this up real quick about the artificial sweeteners, because you're going to love this tie-in, okay? So World War One happens. Now, they found out way back in 18 Bubba that saccharin and aspartame and everything are bad for your health. That's why they always say in moderation. Okay? Mm-hmm. They knew back then there was something wrong. They even have tons of articles on it of overexposure to it, like 90 rats can, you know, poop or something. And then so back in 1901, when World War One was getting big or whatever, that's when they decided to bring back saccharin for the artificial sweetener, because sugar was too much of a commodity back then and cost a lot more money. So that's what they brought it back. And then, like, then it was a war pretty much, because now it's back in circulation. You also had Theodore Roosevelt, who was a diabetic, who said, oh, I can eat the shit out of this without having to worry about any diabetes. So that helped that. So there you go. But in 1977, they did a study where they showed bladder and the cancer in rats, bladder cancer. So, okay.
Well, that's the more you know.
I got to put that in there now. Damn it.
The more you know.
So let's get to a happier thing. Let's talk about misunderstood songs from wherever.
Oh my God! Can I do a TV one real quick, guys?
Sure.
Guys, have you ever heard the lyrics to Frasier's actual theme song?
Yeah,
I don't think so.
Hey, yeah, baby, I hear the blues are calling. Toss salad and scrambled eggs.
Yeah, egg on the face. What's up with that, dude?
I seemed a bit confused, but baby, I got you pegged. I love Frasier.
Frasier's fucking awesome.
I don't know.
Frasier's a great thing, but I was listening to the theme, because I got like TV's greatest hits, and I was kind of high, and I really listened to the lyrics, you know, because I'm like kind of blitzed. I'm like, these lyrics are fucking weird, bro. You know, they don't make any sense.
Oh yeah, it's total junk. I love it.
It's weird.
It's like the point. That's like it's the point of the show. It doesn't make sense.
Mm.
Yeah.
Or is that Seinfeld?
Well, that's Seinfeld.
Seinfeld doesn't have lyrics. Hmm. But every Seinfeld episode has a different theme to it.
Yeah.
That's true. It does.
So Cooper did a bunch of research on this. Do you have anything?
What do you mean?
That's a lot of research.
Okay.
Yeah.
Everybody knows the song Who Let the Dogs Out, right? Who let the dogs out?
Who?
You know that one?
Yes.
Yeah, it is about... God damn, I went down that rabbit hole. It's about men fucking treating women as objects.
I wish a motherfucker would.
So, that's really close, yeah. So Who Let the Dogs Out is actually... You know how men catcall women?
Yeah.
Hey, baby, how you doing? Bazooba guabo, hey. That's the girl's way of talking shit on them. Who let the dogs out? I didn't know that. That's kind of cool.
Isn't that like the scrub song? The scrub song?
I don't want no scrub.
Yeah, oh, yeah. That's kind of like the same thing, right?
Yeah, well, but that's kind of shitty, though. I don't want no scrub. A scrub is a guy who can't get no love from me. Hanging out the passenger side of his best friend's ride, trying to holler at me. That's a little rough, isn't it? They're like saying he's cheap and shit.
Yeah, but pretty honest, though.
Yeah, it's true.
Did you know the Macarena is about a lady that cheats on her boyfriend?
Yeah, with her friends.
Army.
Yeah, yes.
I didn't know that until I got older.
Yeah, I didn't either. I didn't know it until I read about it the other day.
Let's talk about monogamy and fidelity.
Just now.
And Hey Ya, that's my favorite one I read the other day. Hey Ya is about a failing marriage.
Is it really?
Yeah, wait,
the Beatles song, Hey Ya?
No, like,
Hey Ya.
He goes, you don't want to hear me talk. He goes, you just want to dance. So he goes, hey.
Oh, he's making fun of the fact that the song is going to be a popular beat song. Yeah.
Get a step further.
We stepped together.
Outcast. I'm sorry, Miss Jackson was Andre 3000's apology to Erykah Badu's mom.
But who?
You know, Andre 3000 had and Erykah Badu share a child.
Oh, really? I didn't know that.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, and when their relationship failed.
Aww.
Yeah.
Really?
When their relationship failed, Outkast came out with I'm Sorry, Miss Jackson, and that was Andre 3000's apology to
Never
Erykah Badu's
meant
mother.
To make your daughter cry. I apologize. All right.
That's the word on the street.
Word on the street. Blackbird. Blackbird singing in the dead of night.
Well, if you get into those old songs, a lot of them don't mean anything.
Alrighty. So since we're on this subject, I need some clarification from my Caucasian friends here.
Who you calling white?
Oh, wait a second.
This should be good.
This is gonna be a bit of a debate here.
So. I'm actually 1/16th Cherokee.
Okay, so Hotel California by the Eagles.
Yeah.
It's about Hollywood.
It's about Hollywood, but it sounds like it's about a crack house.
No,
it's about Hollywood and the industry of how they abuse their they just abuse their entertainers.
I can get that, but also to me it's like the first couple times I heard it.
Anybody live in the feed can type in anything they want to.
We have people in the feed?
We have people in the feed.
Oh, fancy.
In fact, we're doing a giveaway in the feed tonight.
Oh.
We're finally going to give away that sealed copy of Steel Magnolias?
No, that's a treasured icon.
You get a free 20-piece cheeseburger.
Yeah.
So where's this feed at? I'm new to this tech.
What's the general. Hashtag general.
The Hoodiekye, yeah.
Two messages since...
All right. So, Blackbird, it's about the...
John Lennon.
The Little Rock.
It's about a black woman.
No, it's about the African-American students that were in Little Rock where they got beat up and shit. They wrote the song Blackbird for that. I never knew that. Paul McCartney talked about this in 2016. He said it was, you know, that's what they did it for. The pioneers of the civil rights movement inspired their song Blackbird. So there you go.
Okay. Remember I said I went down a fucking rabbit hole the other day and you told me that this was the topic?
Is he robotic you know to what, you guys too?
Do you know?
Yeah, he's
a robot.
All right, go ahead.
Me?
Yeah, just go ahead. You're good.
Mr. Roboto.
Brown Sugar from the Rolling Stones.
Brown Sugar. I love it.
And it's about a slave woman who got repeatedly whipped and raped.
Oh,
that's about a guy that, you know, liked black women. I thought Jungle Fever.
All right, I have a question for the audience.
Go ahead.
Named Tom, he wants you to ask about Lucy in the Sky with Diamonds.
Everybody knows that. That's about the drugs.
Yeah.
Or if you look at, what is the street name? The street name?
LSD?
No, yeah, it made to LSD, but there was a song about a street name. Lakeshore Drive, that was it. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
It's about the Lakeshore Drive in Chicago.
Oh.
Who sings that? Duran Duran?
No.
They had a song called Lakeshore Drive. Okay, who sings it?
I don't know.
Hold on.
Jimmy Loggins.
No, it's about
Lakeshore Drive is?
Alatoya.
No shit.
Haynes Jeremiah. That's who it is.
All right, everybody knows the Total Eclipse of the Heart song, right?
Yeah.
Once upon
a time. I this yesterday, Pauly.
What?
Fortunately.
I read about this yesterday and I was surprised.
It is. So, do you guys know what this song is about?
Your mom.
Vampires.
Yeah, it's not about boy meets girl. It's actually about, well, the songwriter was named Jimmy Steinman, and he wrote a song on vampires and the fantasy about them. That's why when you hear the lyrics where they're saying, like, your love is like a shadow at the end of the time. I don't know what to do. I'm always in the dark. It's all fantasy vampiring. What is that called? Glamping? No, what is it called?
Glamping is camping, but glamorous. Oh,
what's the thing they do? LARPing. Is that it? I don't know.
LARPing? That's fantasy play and real
live action role play.
What's the vampire one they
glamping?
Do?
Glamping?
Are you referring to, like,
is that okay?
Fan fiction?
I don't know. There was something you do when you do LARPing of whatever. Okay.
Cosplay?
Hard to breathe.
Furries? But...
Furries. Furry vampires.
Arg. Arg. Hard to Breathe by Maroon 5.
Maroon 5.
Maroon 5. It's getting hotter.
And that's against the industry again, too.
Yes, I didn't know that. It was because he was getting stressed out by the pressures of them trying to make live, you know, hits. So Avril Lavigne wrote a song about that. Yeah, what's up? Yeah, that is.
It was Avril Lavigne.
Lakeshore Drive is on
Levine.
Guardians of the Galaxy Volume 2.
Oh.
Nice. Good going.
Oh.
Now, there you go.
And you remember what I told you the other night when I read about Obama?
Yes.
Mr. Roboto.
Can you, like, pull over or something?
Me?
Yeah, like, you're really choppy.
Can't.
Choppy, choppy?
Oh, I'm sorry. Choppy, I'm in choppy. The woods.
What was the other one?
The
One Way or Another by Blondie. One way.
Oh, another. I'm going to find you.
Now, you think it's about a cat and mouse game, right?
I'm going to get you. It's a review of a stalker.
Yeah, it's a stalker song. One way or another, I'm going to find you. I'm going to get you. Oh, that's fucked.
I think that would be more like a serial killer song. Matter of fact, they should publish it right in your next slash horror story. It's like right. Killer singing.
One more question from the peanut gallery.
What in the fuck?
All right, what do we got? What do we got from the miscellaneous pool?
It's the ask about Bruce Springsteen's Born in the USA. Is
oh, yeah. We did that on another show, though. But if you listen to previous shows of ours, Chappie, I think you were on that one where we did the one about like songs with different meanings. But Born in the USA, was used for Ronald Reagan's second term, like for the song.
Yeah.
And it's anti-American. If you ever listen to the lyrics, you know, it's really
It's like
fucked.
A pro-fucking Vietnam song.
No, it's not pro-Vietnam. It's pro-hate, pretty much, because he talks
it's
about...
anti-American.
I mean, it has something to do with Vietnam.
Funny story, that was actually the first album I ever bought.
Oh, wow.
So I guess they hate America.
Oh, there it is right there. It's Born on the End. So I think that's about enough on that one. Oh,
dude,
The Clash, London Calling. Joe, you should have knew this one.
Yeah, that was bashing the royal government.
Yeah.
London Calling.
It was an anti-war of the Falkland Island War that no one wanted to fight.
Yeah.
And a lot of bombs were mailed to the Queen, so servicemen were there checking packages.
Damn that Iron Lady.
Right.
What the?
You know, it's actually similar to
That sounds exactly right, sir.
Are we back in the 80s? Like an 80s video game.
Yeah. Putting a swelling on your eye and your nose even. When I choke you, you stop breathing. And when Jim come, I'm leaving. I feel bad for Cooper because he's like, all right, you guys know any.
Speaking of London Calling, shipbuilding by Elvis Costello was also mocking the war.
Mm.
The Falkland War?
No. I don't know what that is.
Yeah.
Yep, I lost you.
Oh, there you are. Did you know In the Arms of an Angel by Sarah McLachlan?
It's a horrible song. It makes me think of dying puppies.
It is. Damn you.
Oh, I read that too.
Commercial.
I think of the late night infomercials.
Oh, you did?
Money.
You read up on this? Yeah, it's rough. It's about the Smashing Pumpkins keyboardist who died from heroin overdose in 1996.
Yeah.
Who?
Ace of the Dragon.
What? Oh my God.
Joe. Who is it about?
Sarah McLachlan wrote the In the Arms of the Angel. It's about a guy named Jonathan McLovin.
Loving, McLovin.
Whatever. He was a Smashing Pumpkins guitarist, or he was the keyboardist or bassist or whatever who died from an overdose. I remember him not dying, but like I remember that because then that's when Smashing Pumpkins kind of got big, I think.
Oh, you're dead. Now we're big.
You're dead. Woo! Okay.
We've been waiting for you to die our whole lives.
Speaking of Smashing Pumpkins, do you know that song Today is about suicide?
Oh, wow.
Damn.
You got me.
I read
2 days, is the greatest day of them all. All right. All right, here we go. This is for the miscellaneous pool, the miscellaneous chat, whatever. I'm going to pull up the giveaway question. You get it right, just put the answer into the thing. Everyone can play.
Where can I find this chat at?
General, hashtag general.
Hashtag general for all the live people that are going in. It's a new thing we're starting. Don't worry about it. Just I like that. Where's
I like
chat?
How he's never specific about things.
Yeah.
You're just like, oh, everyone's got to know.
Okay, so we're going to use a Disney question this time.
Cryogenic.
I know, right?
Yeah, I'm automatically disqualified because I sent in right next to him, so.
Mm. All right, now everybody can answer, but it's for the live people so they can try to win something. All right? All right, here we go. Which Disney character starred in Steamboat Willie?
Oh, Jesus. Who knows?
How the hell did you get that wrong?
Oh, I don't know what the fuck you're talking about.
I just clicked the button.
I don't either.
Which Disney character starred in Steamboat Willie?
Oh, are we supposed to answer that out loud?
Let's see what they put in the answers in there. Let's get the answer from the live cast here, the live people.
The people, the live audience.
So it's pretty cool because you can utilize everybody in the chat as like a lifeline, you know? So.
My daughter's boyfriend.
Aw.
Can you guys still hear me? Because I'm multitasking.
Yeah, you're fine.
Your hands are quiet. I don't know if I lost you guys.
No, you're fine. I'm waiting for anything to type, I guess. I don't know.
There's like four answers in there.
What is your favorite flavor of Kool-Aid?
The Jim green Jones flavor.
Is.
Blue raspberry.
I don't know Jim why, Jones but I is. Like...
Jim Jones, that's awesome.
My favorite.
I like Country Time Lemonade.
Can we go back to the music stuff?
Yeah, you can start throwing some more stuff out that we missed.
You know the Bryan Adams Summer of 69?
Mm. Yeah.
Was actually about the sexual position of 69.
Oh, that's true.
He was talking about his guitar and how his friends got married. Yeah. And
How's that the position of a 69?
I don't know. I went down a rabbit hole.
He was 69 with a guitar.
Joni got something, blah, blah, got married.
He said it was all about sex.
It was the best. Yeah, he bought a guitar at a thrift shop, right?
What was he jerking off on the guitar?
He was born in like 1960. He goes,
like every 5 minutes on 102.5. They do.
It's all about the G-string.
Oh my gosh.
And,
it's all about a straight line.
I don't know.
He never said how much he paid for that guitar, though.
Oh, really? What's this one about?
Margaritaville with Jimmy Buffett.
About getting drunk.
Was the demise of a was the demise of a person. Like, it was like Nicolas Cage and fucking Leaving Las Vegas. Someone who's just fucking drinking his life away. That's what Margaritaville is about.
Where's the salt? Where's the freaking salt?
Exactly. I've been there. Yeah. I usually say, where's my smokes?
A song that reminds me of the summer of 69 is Butthole Surfer's Avalanche.
What?
Wait, what?
Because, okay,
something
so you
about
have,
surfing buttholes.
Yeah, so you have like Bruce Springsteen and John Cougar Mellencamp and Brian Adams have these long songs that talk about life in a certain time period. Well, that you also have what? Avalanche by Butthole Surfers. You have Those the People Who Died. That's another one.
Did you not come up with a better band name than Butthole Surfers?
Maybe.
I mean...
Great song is.
We're talking about Pauly here.
Love Shack of B52.
If you see a faded sign.
In my head, on anyone's shoulder, cause I can't be with you.
Marky got with Sharon, and Sharon got Sharia. She was sharing Sharon's outlook on the topic of disease.
We need to talk about our Indiana promo. Promo.
You want to do the
Indiana Jones and the Temple of what?
So we are going to we got our media passes secured for the Indianapolis PopCon. Is that right to say PopCon? Whatever.
Yeah, Indy PopCon. Yeah.
So we've been spending. We had to change our plans for all of August and everything because we had to start in part of July because we had to get all the rules and regulations down and try to get our hotel room and all this other stuff and get it all done. So we got that done. This morning, we got a little bad news, everybody.
Oh, denied?
It was denied for our Chicago con. And that's the big one. So,
fuck Chicago.
What was denied?
Our media passes.
Yeah, we pretty much got like, nope, you're not. We're sorry. Try again.
Yeah, thank you. Please come again.
They thought you were Alex Jones, didn't they, Paul?
The frogs are gay. Yeah. So now let me show you. This is called the Fan Expo of Chicago, right? Now let me just walk through some of these actors that are going to be there, so you can see kind of why. You know what I mean? So, celebrity-wise, we have just about the full cast of the Back to the Future. You get Michael J. Fox, Christopher Lloyd, Leah Thompson, and Biff.
Biff. Oh, Biff?
Yeah.
McFly!
Would you have Michael J. Fox open a soda for you?
Hell
Make
yeah.
Like a tree and get out of here.
Hey, he's going to do open heart surgery soon.
Okay, and here else is who we have on the list. We had Chevy Chase, Zachary Levi, Sam Rainey, Kiefer Sutherland.
You said Sam Rainey?
Yes. Sam Rainey is going to be there.
Oh, my God.
We got the guy from Lord of the Rings, the Smeagol. You got...
Did you say Chevy Chase?
Yes. Yeah. Pretty much National Lampoon's going to be there. Randy Quaid's going to be there.
He's such a dick.
Yep, Randy Quaid's going to be there. Chevy Chase, the two kids.
Randy Quaid's not allowed in like the United States, right?
Yeah, but he's there now, so he must have got it fixed.
He's beaming in via satellite.
Now you get the Lost Boys.
Hey guys, I'm back.
You get the Lost Boys. You get both of them. You get Kiefer Sutherland and the guy who played Michael. You get Zachary Levi from Shazam. You get
Do you get one Frog Brother, Paul?
You get only one Frog Brother. No, you don't get none of them. We got the Addams Family because you have Christopher Lloyd. You have Christy Ricci.
I would like to see that.
Danny Trejo is supposed to be there.
Yep, Danny Trejo is going to be there. You have the people from, did you guys watch, what is that? The Mandalorian or Breaking Bad? They're going to be there.
Oh, yeah. Moth Gideon, Bo-Katan, and the Architect.
And Echo.
I know. I'm sorry. Yeah, Moth Gideon's going to be there. His name is...
Giancarlo Esposito?
Yes. He's going to be there.
He's going to be there? Nice.
Steve Burns from Blue's Clues.
Nice. Yes.
Mm-hmm. Blue's Clues?
I'm in for that.
Diamond Phillips.
Oh! Really?
Yes.
Wait,
that's awesome.
You get
Diamond Phillips.
Lou Diamond Phillips.
Oh,
you're getting Dermot Mulroney. He's been in tons of movies. He was in Young Guns 2. Yep.
Was he in Showgirls?
I don't know.
Or is that Dermot McDillon?
That's Dylan McDermott.
All right. You get Anthony Michael Hall.
What?
Yeah.
Farmer Ted.
National Lampoon people are going to be there. Yeah. You get Christy Brinkley. You get the Flash TV show cast. You get Tom Cavanaugh, Carlos You get
Daniel Panabaker.
Christy Brinkley.
You get Brent Spiner from Star Trek.
Data?
Yes. You get, I don't know, some of these. Henry Winkler's going to be there.
No. The Fonz.
Mm-hmm. Are you ready for this one? You get Peter Weller, RoboCop himself.
Don't move, creep.
Yeah.
Yes.
No one.
Dead or alive, you're coming with me.
Poor guy lost his hand for you guys.
Paul Walter Hauser. He played Stingray. Yeah. Did you guys watch Cobra Kai?
Yeah, Peter Weller was also the voice of Batman.
What?
Yeah, he was the voice of Batman in Return of the Dark Knight, the cartoon.
Okay. Yeah. Now we have voice actors here too, of all the animes, including The Little Mermaid.
What about Felicia Day?
She's not here. But you get Dora the Explorer, Joe.
Ooh.
Hola. Hello.
It's the map. It's the map. It's the map. It's the map.
Zeman Slayer and stuff like that. Yeah. Oh, you get the voice of the guy from Five Nights at Freddy.
JJ would love that.
Yeah. You get the voice of Mario. Mario's going to be there. You have the voice of
Solid Snake.
Yep. Metal Gear Solid Snake. Just a bunch of fucking people here. This is like the Mecca. And here's the reason why. Because
Nicolas Cage is the Mecca.
Oh, nice. Yeah. Yes.
No, Nicolas Cage. Not going.
Now, here's the thing.
Yeah, Cage or go fuck yourself.
I like that. Like I said, we're really downhearted. We didn't get our media passes because that's like an open door to get up and get up on these people's grills and really just, yeesh.
You don't think they listened to your show and said, oh, hell no. You know,
maybe you never know. No, they have like, this is the big leagues kind of. Everyone who's going there that's media is like big influential people. So,
yeah, what about Angry Video Gamer? Is he going to be there?
He could be there. Game you never know.
Chicago's the third largest con. You mean you got San Diego, New York, and then Chicago. That's the top three cons. So,
yeah.
Like the big three, huh?
So it's a big thing to try to get into this. So we kind of understood that going in there, but it is kind of depressing because here's what we did. We took an itemized list of everybody who we wanted to meet, greet, get an autograph, and a picture taken with them. Because they even have group pictures. So we figured since we didn't get our media passes, how much would it cost us to go and get this done on our own?
$350. $350. $5K.
Very close, my friend. Very close. So, yes. So for me, it's $5,799. Just here's an idea. To get
Nicolas Cage needs to be there for that much.
Nicolas Cage needs to drink with you.
To walk up.
Oh, shit.
The most expensive person to go and see is Michael J. Fox for $225.
I want him to shake my soda off.
Okay, so you guys want the group photos, right? So you want the Back to the Future photo that you get Christopher Lloyd, Michael J. Fox, Leah Thompson, and Biff. That's 500 bones for one picture.
Oh, would you ask Leah Thompson if she slept with that duck?
No, but I'll try to grab Leah Thompson because I was telling Jamie, that was my first. Okay, so my first crush was the chick from Labyrinth, right? Jennifer Connelly. I think everybody had a crush on her.
Ass to ass.
But my first hubba hubba crush was Leah Thompson.
You ever seen Requiem for a Dream? That's her.
I know, right? But my first
Requiem for a Dream. Who was in that?
Yeah, Jennifer Connelly.
What was yours? One. Your total was, so Jamie's was a little less than mine.
910.
910.
You need the little sound bites of the punch code sound bite, you know, the little cash register.
Yeah. Oh, dude, let me show you another one. Let me show you another one. Just to get another group photo of the Lost Boys, right? So you get Keith Sutherland, you get Patrick, whatever his name is, and, well, I think that's it.
Yeah, that hey, there's one, no Emilio Estevez?
No.
Corey Phillips?
Emilio!
No, you don't get Emilio. For the Lost Boys, $200. The National Lampoon's
cast
$500 for one picture.
What's the cast though?
$450 of that goes to Chevy Chase.
That's a good one. You get Chevy
Who's
Chase.
All there?
Randy Quaid. You get the two kids, Anthony and Michael.
What about
Hall,
Beverly D'Angelo?
No, she didn't make
Which
it.
Which kids? Which kids though?
Michael.
Yeah, they
Michael
the kids
Anthony
every movie.
Hall.
Yeah, no, they like and new kids every show.
Farmer Ted.
Farmer Fred. Yeah. The cheapest person to get was who's that guy?
Exactly.
$5.
He's well. Most...
I mean, I wouldn't have spent a dollar to get a picture taken with a guy or someone that was in a movie.
So most of the people have about $60 for a photo, or $80 for a photo, except for Michael J. Fox and Christopher Lloyd. They're like really expensive. Zach Levy, you played Shazam, $120. So. Kiefer Sutherland's 125. While Leah Thompson,
if Shaquille O'Neal actually played in Shazam, do you think the entire universe would explode?
Oh, that'd be funny.
Because of the Mandela effect.
Oh, Cobra Kai guy is Paul Hauser. He's the cheapest one. But here we go. Okay, so Randy Quaid, 120, but he has
Randy
legal
Quaid,
fees
did,
to play.
He I was gonna ask that. He beat those legal troubles that he had.
Yeah.
Trying to sneak back over in the border from Canada and got busted.
What did he get in trouble for, guys?
Felony vandalism.
Being crazy.
Well, I saw that. I saw that weird video with him and that girl. Yeah, but what else did he do?
Shitter's full.
Meth?
Hey, you went, I don't know. You know what? Let me look that up. I really don't know.
The most I would spend for a celebrity to get my picture taken, I'd give $10 to Booger from Revenge of the Nerds to get a picture taken. That's it. That's as far as I go.
Joe Armstrong? He was the actor.
Booger.
Oh, no, it's Curtis Armstrong. Curtis Armstrong. Was the actor. Played Booger.
I didn't know his name. I only know him as Booger. But I'll give $1,000 to Nick Cage.
Randy Quaid.
Later.
Okay, so Randy Quaid.
Au revoir.
What did he do? What did he do that caused him to get in trouble?
He went fucking batshit crazy, and he did. He went on a fucking anti-United States shit, and he ran up to, I think he went ran up to Canada. I don't know.
All right, so Randy Quaid and his wife were arrested in Texas in 2009 for defrauding an innkeeper. Burglary and conspiracy charges that took place all in California. So they fled to Texas. They were arrested stemmed from an incident in which Quaid and his wife illegally left a hotel without paying. Whoa, a $10,000 bill. They were released on bail and then paid most of the bill and then like fled the country. The couple was also previously arrested also in Canada for felony vandalism.
But how did they get you kicked out of the U.S.?
No, he took off. Stop. He took off for Canada to hide, and then he got in trouble in Canada, too.
You know, if you're hiding, you really should keep it on the deal.
There you go. All right, everybody. Well, thank you everyone so very much for participating and being in this show and a lot of stuff. Now, for all listeners out there, there's going to be another giveaway on the Facebook page, Miscellaneous Podcast Facebook page. All right, where you get to choose. If you get the answer right, we'll randomly pull somebody, and you get to choose from either Kira's magic box. What was it?
Magical treasure
box. It all sounds dirty. Kira's magical treasure box or Pauly's cardboard box. There you go.
I just want Pauly's box. That sounds more interesting.
Please check us out on all platforms. Please give us some feedback. At the end of the show, you guys are going to hear we got a few things. We have Google messages and stuff like that we got. All right? Everybody say goodbye.
Bye.
Bye-bye.
Hello.
Bye.
Oh, goodbye.
Blah, blah, blah.